I'm busy, Spinelli. I
come in peace and to offer a proposal.
What
do you want? We must join forces to save Maxie.
I'm sorry, are you talking to me?
My words were intended for no one else.
Are you serious? You do realize that we fight all the time. We agree on nothing.
Except for the most important thing. Maxie did not kill Lisa Niles. And we have to find out who did. The agents of law enforcement are stymied, okay? Maximista's guilty plea has tied their hands. But we can operate outside the system and vindicate her.
I understand that you're worried about her, as am I. But we really just need to let Alexis do her job.
There's nothing left to do. The judge has accepted Maximista's guilty plea. All that's left is her sentence.
I understand how it works. Thank you very much.
Well, then why are you not more upset? I mean, Alexis can argue for lenience, but that'll what? Shave a few years off a life sentence?
I get it. I get it. It sucks. It sucks.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. Your tone is conveying acceptance, even resignation. Do I have to remind you that Maxie is innocent?
I would like to believe that, but what if she's not?
Do you think that this is easy for me? Do you think I'm enjoying this?
That's not an answer. Look, she confessed to not one, but two murders.
In the throes of grief and emotional turmoil.
Well, she had ample time to come forward and say that wasn't true. Even when Patrick went to go talk to her and says, I don't blame you for Robin's death. You would think at that time she would come forward. But maybe the truth is that she did kill Lisa. And it happened when she was panicking. And
look, you can't complete a thought because it is impossible. Even if Maxie killed the heinous Dr. Niles, there is no way that she plotted the murder of a completely innocent first mate Briggs.
She confessed.
She also confessed to killing Robin.
Okay, that is completely different. Okay, we know that got caught on the valve and that's what caused the explosion. It was an accident.
Yeah, but Maxie cannot accept that.
Okay, well, maybe there is more to the entire alibi than we really know. Okay? Maybe that's why she doesn't have an alibi for what happened that night. Why does she know so much about first mate Briggs' fake suicide
note? Okay, Maxie is very skilled at manipulating the truth to her purposes. And yes, she has some association with the Elders of Carr, and she may have knowledge of the demise of first mate Briggs, but that does not make her a killer.
Unfortunately, she managed to convince the judge otherwise.
That was her goal all along. Don't you see, if Maxie can't be punished for the crime that she thinks she committed,
she wants to get punished for a crime that she didn't commit. To her. I gotta go.
What? I think
if she can't punish herself like this, it's wrong.
Exactly the sentiment that I share when I'll see you.
We're not doing this again.
We will if we have to.
Look, I am her boyfriend.
Yeah. It was my distinct impression that you were taking a break.
But we shouldn't be.
Well, would Maxie agree?
I don't know. I will ask her when I see her.
No. I'm not gonna let you trade on a brief and trivial relationship that caused Maxie more heartache than joy just to pull rank.
What? Like what you are doing left and right? I am her boyfriend.
I am her best friend.
I love her.
So do I.
So what are we doing?
What we always do? Our default setting?
And these spitting matches are not helping anyone, definitely not helping Max.
We both have tried to appeal to her in our own ways, and she won't listen to either of us.
You were right.
I was?
We do have to work together on this. And we have to step it up.
Obtained a copy of the official police file.
And what'd you come up with?
Well, I've gone through it backwards and forwards, and there has to be a missing element.
Clearly. Otherwise, the cops would have come up with the real killer.
Right. But all is not lost. It might be time-consuming, but we have to start from the top. Consider all the suspects that the authorities have.
Hey, you got anybody in mind?
We can start with her.
Greetings.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi.
Perhaps you recall when I asked for your assistance in proving Maxie's innocence?
Yeah, I remember. What do you need?
Okay, well, the night of the party boat scandal, you made an early exit, correct?
If that's what you want to call being thrown overboard.
Right, well, prior to that unfortunate incident, do you recall any of the goings-on at sea?
You know, I gave a statement to the police.
Yeah, oh, no, I'm aware of your statement.
You are?
Have you remembered anything since?
Like what?
I don't know, something you heard or someone you saw?
Spinelli's not trying to accuse you of anything. Maxie's innocent. We're just trying to prove that it was somebody else on board who actually killed Lisa.
I know, and I wish there was something I could tell you guys, but the last time I saw Lisa, she was very much alive. Next thing I knew, I was being pulled out of the water by
some mystery guy with some dabs.
Perhaps he has the answers that we seek.
Actually, he's not a mystery anymore.
You actually know who that is?
Dr. Keenan.
most fortuitous.
It is?
Yeah, perhaps Dr. Keenan saw something that could help exonerate Maxie.
Oh, I doubt it. He said he had to get right back to Windermere after he pulled me out of the water.
Why didn't he say anything up until now?
He said he didn't want to make a big deal out of it. Well, I have many patients to see. Let me know if I can help you guys.
Okay, thank you. Me or does something not add up about this story? Why would you save someone and then just take off?
Unless you had something to hide.
I think we have ourselves a suspect.